Okay, I've got everything in a carburetor cleaner tank, but I want to point out a couple things. These two bolts, and they're the ones that were pulled out of the side of the housing, they have an O-ring on them. And if you put that O-ring in that carb cleaner, it'll probably destroy it. So I'm not going to clean these until I get the new O-rings to make sure that I can get new O-rings. If I cannot get them, or I can't find some in my collection that will fit that, then I want to be able to reuse these. So just point that out. You do have some O-rings there, and those should be replaced. And this is what I use to clean carburetor parts and other things. And if you don't have a big parts cleaner, this is a good small investment. They're not that expensive, and you can use it to clean your parts. It comes with a basket, and you just drop all the parts in there. Holes are small enough that even those small guides will be okay in there. And it's non-corrosive to metal. It's also safe on aluminum. Now, I wouldn't leave aluminum in here overnight, but for 30 minutes is what I do. And then pull them out and give them a good wash to remove all of the chemical on it, and you should be good to go. You might have to lightly scrub it with a, you know, brass toothbrush kind of thing. So that's about all I'll have to do after I get them out of here. Okay, so I've got some of the parts for the power valve nice and clean. We're still working on a few other things, and the ones that are caked up pretty good with carbon buildup. In the meantime, I'm gonna let it soak. I've already let it soak for 30 minutes, pulled it out, scrubbed it, put it back in. I'm gonna let it soak for another 30. Again, these are just the heavy parts. But one of the pieces is aluminum, so I don't want to leave it overnight. The other thing is, while that's going on, I'm going to see if I can't tackle this carburetor and clean it up and check and make sure the float and everything is working fine and all the passages are clean on it. When I pulled it out, I noticed that this carburetor was very, very dirty on the intake. And not sure what we're going to find inside the bowl. So we're going to, if you put this carburetor on a freshly rebuilt engine, you're going to take all that dirt and grime that's in here. It's going to get sucked into the engine, or whatever's in the gas here also gets sucked into the engine, and going to ruin your day. So we'll start taking this carburetor apart. First thing I'm going to do is take these hoses off. These are just tubes. Sorry about that, guys. These are just clips that hold the tubes. And up here you've got some retaining clips that you just undo with a pair of needle nose and slide the retainers up and out of the way. And then the hose comes off. So I'm gonna work on that, and I'll get those hoses off first. Okay, the hoses are off now from both these vents, and then just slide the whole thing off. Set it off to the side. And this is so chewed up here. This is the idle adjustment screw, and it's so chewed up. I have to order a new one of those. Man, this was a rough carburetor. And you know what? Before I start anything, I'm going to clean up the outside here. That's much better, isn't it? It's about 30 seconds with some carburetor cleaner. Spray it on the outside. Took a nylon brush, brushed it, and so much easier to work on, nicer to work on. I can see things better, see cracks in the aluminum if there are any. Anyway, I like to work on clean parts. So I'm going to grab a screwdriver, already have a beer going, and we're going to get this float pole off next. Now we're going to get the float pole off. And these hose retainers are held on by these screws, and when we remove these, we won't know where they go unless you make note of that. So just make note of the fact that the hose retaining rings are on the side of the fuel line, and we'll be able to get them back. Not that it would make that big a difference, but it might interfere with something. And we know this is the way it came out, so it's better to put it back that way. Oh, great. I knew I'd find something else wrong with this thing. I have a strip screw here. It's frustrating, guys. If you strip a screw, we've all done it. No big deal. Buy a new one and buy the correct part. It really bothers me when guys do maintenance on something and then just pass down their problems to the next guy who buys it. And that is so rounded off. I doubt even an impact wrench will help, but I'm going to try that next. Okay, well, it was so rounded out that even an impact wrench couldn't get it. Of course, if it doesn't have a Phillips head bit, can't grab it with it. But they stuck out far enough, I was able to get a pair of pliers and break it loose with that. So, moral of that story is, buy the right parts. Which, you know, leads me to wonder how long it's been since this float pole's been removed if you can't take the screws out to service it. You know what I'm saying? So, we'll take a look here at the needle valve and make sure it's operating correctly. Alright, and it is. So that's a good sign. Hopefully all we have to do here is order a new screw and go to the hardware store, buy the correct screw, and then spray some carb cleaner on the inside of this, and we'll be on our way. We'll see how it goes. So, and I'm also going to order a set of jets for it, so that I'm going to go two sizes high, two sizes low on both the main jet and the idle jet, just to make sure that we can tweak it a little bit. So, remove the float, and you don't want to, you want to get that float out of the carburetor anytime you're doing work on the, you're cleaning with a carb cleaner, because it's plastic. You don't want to get that full of carb cleaner. But you just push the pin out. I brought the zoom in a little bit so you guys can see better. I hope that this I don't get out of focus here or out of the picture. Just push the pin out from one end. Comes out very easily. Should be no force. Make sure you don't lose that. Then you can lift the float assembly. And the needle, which came out. This needle is covered with a plastic type tip, so you don't want to get carb cleaner on that. And but I'm just gonna look and see. I'm looking for a ridge that's built in there from seating on the seat. And sometimes when that happens, it starts to leak right there. But this carburetor didn't have a leaking issue, so and the seat looks real good. I'm just going to clean that with soap and water. I'm not going to use any carb cleaner on that. But that looks good. The O-rings look good. It didn't look like it was leaking out of the O-rings, but I do see some I'm not sure what this is from. It's some on the inside of it and some on the outside of it. And actually somebody had put a grease on there or something, so that was good. So I'm going to order the idle speed adjustment, one of the screws for the float bowl, the jets. And I'm going to take this jet off here to see what size I have to, what size is in there, compare it to stock. And I think that's all we'll have to do outside of blowing carb cleaner through all the holes and making sure that it's all the passages are clear. And I just want to add that the float bowl is very clean. Kind of shocking. I'm very surprised there. But happily surprised. Okay, so two things I'm going to do here. I removed this plastic idle speed control. I'm going to replace that. It's so chewed up you can't get a screwdriver to adjust it. So this, don't lose this spring, that's reusable. But this is just a plastic piece, really kind of a poor design. Should be made out of aluminum or pot metal or something that'll hold up better than plastic, because it does have some pressure with that spring on there. It's a pretty good tension spring, and that spring is there to keep it from backing out on its own. The other thing that I did was I took a, I believe this is a 6mm, yes, it is a 6mm wrench or socket. Get it on this jet here and pull it out. And I want to inspect it to make sure that it's open, and it's barely open. I can see some crud in it, very small hole. I'll kind of hold it up to the light, and you can see. But yeah, that's all clogged up there. And it is a number 180, and I'll compare that to stock. Okay, the other thing that you need to do is get yourself a good screwdriver, as wide a blade as you can, and you're going to go into this hole here, right next to where that main jet was, So this hole right here, and it's way down in there, so you have to get a screwdriver that will fit. Some of these are too wide, and I've had to at times grind these sides down a little bit to get a screwdriver in there. As wide a blade as you can get, and twist that screw out. Try not to damage the top of it. And this is a number 40. So we'll look at those, and I'm going to order a set of jets and a few other pieces, and we'll go from there. The other thing I wanted to show you was, here is the power valve. Now, I took this in a bead blaster. Now, I have the luxury of a bead blaster, but two things. You don't need a bead blaster. You can do this. I had it pretty clean with carb cleaner. This is metal. It's steel. So, you know, it is steel. So you can soak this in that carb cleaner for 24 hours or longer if you need to. Just let it soak in there. You're not going to do any damage to it. The other thing is, if you use a bead blaster, now you're charged with making sure that you get every little bit of glass bead out of there, or you'll destroy the head of your engine. So, you know, it has to be washed very carefully before you put it in. But that's what it looks like. And this, maybe you can see now, this pin, this is the control bolt that lifts that valve, and it goes in. Mosquitoes are horrible tonight. Goes in on one side, turns, and then catches and lifts it up. It just catches on those two pins right there with these ears on the side of that. And let me just show you this piece here. This is the exhaust cover, and you see, look at the videos as I removed it, and you can see how black this piece was. It almost looked like a separate piece, and you can tell that it's aluminum now. And I could have bead blasted this, but this was not bead blasted. This was just cleaned with a little elbow grease and carb cleaner and parts cleaner and just whatever I have laying around the shop. You can see still a little bit of carbon in there, which I, you know, had I bead blasted that, I would have gotten that off, but I'm going to try and scrape some of that off. Just carefully scrape as much as you can off of it, and part will be good as new now. Showing no wear at all, so it's good.